वेलकम क्लास, टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू विद चैप्टर 11 द प्रेजेंट टेंस। इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो वी वर रीडिंग अबाउट द प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस। सो द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस इज सब्जेक्ट प्लस इजम आर प्लस वी वन प्लस आईएनजी प्लस ऑब्जेक्ट और कॉम्प्लीमेंट। सो दिस वॉज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस। नाउ वी विल रीड हाउ टू फॉर्म नेगेटिव सेंटेंसेज इन प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस। आई एम नॉट प्लेइंग क्रिकेट, ही इज नॉट रनिंग, वी आर नॉट कुकिंग। सो दीज आर द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ नेगेटिव सेंटेंसेज इन प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस। सो टू फॉर्म नेगेटिव सेंटेंस इन प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस, नॉट इज एडेड बिटवीन द ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब एंड द मेन वर्ब। सो ऑलवेज वी विल एड नॉट इन बिटवीन auxiliary verb and main verb. Auxiliary verb means helping verb. So the structure is subject plus ism are plus not plus present participle plus object or complement. So ism are is the auxiliary verb and present participle, which is v1 plus ing. So not is added in between of them. Interrogative sentence in present continuous tense. So how we will form interrogative sentence in present continuous tense? See, examples are given. Is Ankit playing football? Are you doing your homework? Are we getting late? Here, to form interrogative sentence, the sentence will always start with the auxiliary verb. Auxiliary verb means is, am, are. These are the auxiliary verbs. And to form interrogative sentence in present continuous tense, we will always start the sentence with an auxiliary verb. See the structure: is, am, are plus subject plus present participle means v1 plus ing and plus object or complement, and a question mark should be there. Now we will read the present perfect tense. What is the present perfect tense? The present perfect tense is used for talking about an event happening in a time period beginning in the past and leading to the present. So present perfect tells us about a event or about a work which has started in the past period, but it is still leading to the present. It is still happening in the present. So this tells us about the present perfect tense. Here examples are given. We have eaten our meal. She has given me her book. Here has, have. This indicates that the sentence is in present perfect tense. So these are the examples of present perfect tense. And to form sentences in present perfect tense, the structure is given below: subject plus have or has plus V3 plus object or complement. So this is the structure to form sentence in present perfect tense. What are the uses of present perfect tense? To indicate an action that has just been completed. Have you taken my pen? So whenever we will indicate an action which is just completed in that particular moment, it expresses present perfect tense. The second point tells us that present perfect tense expresses past actions time of which it is not given. I have dropped a 10 rupee note somewhere. So present perfect tense denotes actions which had commenced in the past period and the particular time is not given of that period. So present perfect tense indicate that type of sentences. Third point says to express an action that began in the past and still continues. So third point says that those actions which began in the past period and it is still continuing in the present period indicate that the sentence is in present perfect tense. See the example: I have not heard from you since 2 months. So the work had begun 2 months ago and it is still continuing. So this sentence indicates that it is in present perfect tense. Number 4 says that to express action which took place in the past but the result which we can see or feel in the present time. So the fourth point says that it expresses any kind of action which has taken place in the past and the result we can see or feel in future time. Like example, I have been to Manali twice. So it has begun in the past period and the result we see it in the present period. So this sentence indicates that it is in present perfect tense. Now we will see how to form negative sentence in present perfect tense. Read the sentences. These are the examples. He has not bought a camera. They have not helped us. So to form negative sentence in present perfect tense, not is added just between the auxiliary verb and the main verb. Like subject, the structure is this: subject plus have or has plus not plus past participle plus object or complement. So this is the structure. Has and have is the auxiliary verb and past participle will be the main verb, and the verb must be in form of past participle. How to form interrogative sentence in present perfect tense? To form interrogative sentence in present perfect tense, the sentence must start with auxiliary verb. See the sentence, it must start with has or have. This is the auxiliary verb. After that, subject must be written. After subject, past participle should be written. And after past participle, object or complement should be written. Now we will read about the present perfect continuous tense. What does this mean? The present perfect continuous tense is used for indicating an action that began in the past and is still continuing. So, present perfect continuous tense tells us about any kind of work which began in the past period and it is still continuing till now. Examples: he have been playing football for 2 hours. They have been using their car for 5 hours. So, these two works has started in the past period and it is still continuing now. So this is the examples of present perfect continuous tense. What are the uses of present perfect continuous tense? It expresses an action that began in the past and is still continuing. So mainly present perfect continuous tense tells us about the action which is beginning in the past and it is still continuing on. So the example: it has been raining for 2 hours. The rain, it has started before 2 hours and it is still raining. So this is an example of present perfect continuous tense. So to form a sentence in present perfect continuous tense, auxiliary verb like has or have are also used, followed by been before the present participle form of the verb. So mainly the structure is being described here. The main structure of present perfect continuous tense is subject plus has or have. Has or have is very important in present perfect continuous tense. After has or have, we will put been, then V1 plus ing plus object and complement. So the structure will form. Now, how we will form negative sentence in present perfect continuous tense? We will write not just between the auxiliary verb and been. See the structure: subject plus has or have plus not plus been plus present participle plus object or complement. See here, my mother, this is the subject, has not been keeping well for the last 2 weeks. So this example, just follow the structure which is given here. Interrogative sentence in the present perfect continuous tense. How we will form interrogative sentence in the present perfect continuous tense? We just have to write first has or have, then subject, after subject been, then present participle which is V1 plus ing, and after that we will add the complement or object. So this is the structure of interrogative sentence in present perfect continuous tense. Now we will come to the use of since and for. When to use since and when to use for? Since is used when a precise idea of time is given about the beginning of an action. So we will use since when an exact idea of time, when an exact time period is given, when an exact idea is given about the time that when the action is beginning. Like, I have been working in the firm since May 1996. So an exact time is given that I have been working since May 1996. An exact date is given. Here it has been raining since 7 a.m. 7 a.m. it is an exact time. So we will use since with these sentences. For is used when a duration is given. So for is used in the sentences where duration is given. Like, Anita has been taking dance classes for 8 months. Here a time duration is given that she has been taking the classes for 8 months. It has been raining for 3 days. Here, time period of raining is given that it is raining for 3 days. So, this was where we will use since and where we will use for. So, students, today we have completed chapter 11. Your homework is to go through the chapter. In our next video, we will start chapter 12. So, that's all for today. Thank you.